First of all, I'd like to thank everyone. This will be short for me. I'd like to thank everyone for rolling up. This is an awesome attendance. Obviously, people didn't fall for all the bullshit that was being peddled in the media and by Dr. Napthine. So congratulations and thanks very much to all the unions that have participated, students, and even just general mothers and general members of the public. It is awesome and a fantastic turnout. You're going to be congratulated. Now, the last time I looked, we weren't in Bangladesh. You would have seen our factories clipped in Bangladesh. Well, you know what? We don't live in Bangladesh. We live in Melbourne, where people can expect to walk down the most prominent street in Melbourne, Swanson Street, and not get killed by a brick wall. As far as I'm concerned, I think it's an absolute disgrace. The builder of that site, Grocon, four deaths, Billy Ramsey, crane driver, a few weeks before, it is just absolutely unacceptable and no one wants to take responsibility. We have said all along, come out and say something to the people of Melbourne, give them a bit of confidence that this ain't going to happen again. What do we hear from the government? The silence is deafening. We hear absolutely nothing. Yet, when the unions protested about OH&S last year outside Grocon, Robert Clark, the Attorney General, was saying he was going to use the full force of the law against construction unions.
Right.
All these people come out and say they're going to use the full force of the law, and what a disgrace it was. And you know what happens? Four people get killed in a matter of not even 2 months. And what do we hear? Nothing. Nothing at all. And then in the last few days, the despicable politicians that get up and want to condemn us for showing a minute's silence and respect to people that have died, I'll tell you what, they ought to have a good look at themselves in the mirror, because they ought to be ashamed of themselves. We don't hear them condemning builders for unsafe sites. We've got all the evidence on Grocon. We've got a DVD that's been released to all the media outlets. People will see what we've been talking about. And when we had our protest over OH&S, all these politicians, their golden boy was Daniel Grocon. Grollo. You don't hear that now. You don't hear him backing him now. But they're quick to attack us. All we want is safe sites. We work in the building industry. And you know what? We all want to come home. All our families want to come home. And the one question you want to ask is, if your kids or your partner was working in the building industry, would you want it to be a union site with properly elected OH&S reps?
Yes!
Or would you rather they work on a Grocon site with ex-bouncers and thugs, the construction manager's son, as the OH&S reps? Because that's what's happening at the moment. One of them's an ex-nightclub bouncer. Nothing wrong with bouncers most of the time. But never worked on a building site in his life. Went and done a two-day course. He's now OH&S rep. Absolute disgrace. Peter Hewitt. What a joke. Daniel Van Camp is John Van Camp's son. He's the national construction manager. I'm sure the blokes from the Grocon side have great confidence in going up to him and saying, excuse me, we've got a big problem here, we can't be doing this. You know what happens? You get sent to the departure lounge. We know what happens, and that's what happens on Grocon sites. Grocon will be sorted out in the end. We are not trying to politicise this. Straight after a wall collapse, for those that don't know, a lot of the CFMEU staff, first aiders, a lot of the girls, officials, even a lot of members that were in the office went across the road, and what we witnessed we will never forget. And let's hope Dennis Napthine and some of his government never have to witness that, because we were there that day. He was nowhere to be seen. No one nowhere saying anything to give Melburnians confidence that it wasn't going to happen again. And now the big cover-up has already started. A wall comes down. Within hours, Grocon are allowed to go in there and clean it up. It'd be like us shooting someone and being allowed to clean up our own crime scene. Absolute disgrace. So, WorkSafe have a lot to answer for. WorkSafe might as well walk around seeing eye dogs. I mean, they walk on building sites, they do nothing. They are there to protect our interests also. When you work on a site and a WorkSafe inspector comes on, he should be looking at every aspect. I'll give you just one quick story. After Billy Ramsey died, a few wives rang the union office, concerned. There was crane drivers going up through the towers at the Emporium site. They were using their mobile phones as lights so they could see where they were going, through the towers. Now, we just had a bloke that's just died, and here we have, days later, people using their mobile phones as torches to see where they were going. Now, our health and safety unit had to go down there, fill out an ARIA, and tell Grocon to put more lighting in there. Now, what did WorkSafe do when they went into the site? What were they looking at? Must they have blinkers on? I don't know. It's an absolute disgrace. It's unacceptable. But the bottom line is, you all make me proud today. Because sometimes we fall for all that media stuff. When they say, oh, you're doing this wrong, you're doing that wrong. You know what? When there's so many of them coming out and saying we're doing it wrong, we must be doing it right. Because... in the end, we are not going to let this get covered up. This is not going to get covered up. It's not going to get swept under the carpet. No politician is going to help his mate, because in the end, what Dennis Napthine should remember, they only hold the state by one seat. And in the end, construction workers and their families, they get to vote. So they ought to remember that. They seem to have this absolute hatred for unions, and especially construction unions. For what reason, I don't know. Maybe they're jealous of some of our conditions that we've all had to fight for over the years. One of the comments we made is, if we weren't going to the wall to show a minute's silence and a bit of respect, we would have been condemned saying we're insensitive, right? So no matter what we've done, it was always going to be the wrong thing. But by the turnout we've had today, he's made me all proud. Good on yous. We are not going to let him sweep this under the carpet.